at the starting lineups for tonight's matchup. Missouri with Denman, Dixon, Kim English, Ricardo Ratliff, and Lawrence Bowers. Guys that can really run the floor and play hard for a few minutes, and then they go to the bench. Dixon, Kashmir, Wright. They're as good as Wright is on a given night. Bishop, Ibrahima Thomas, and the aforementioned Yancy Gates, starting five for Cincinnati.
Well, and Mick Cronin was saying he's glad he had all the time to prepare for Missouri because nobody in the Big East plays like them, so they just were playing against traps after traps and steals and then gambling defense, and it really helped to not have them on the second game as opposed to this game.
Mentioning influences, his dad, Hep, scout for the Atlanta Braves, and Rick Pitino tutored him for a couple of years. And there's Mike Anderson, Melvin Watkins, the veteran assistant and former head coach himself by his side. And tonight's game is brought to you in HD TV by LG. Life's good. Our officiating crew, a veteran one, John Higgins, along with Terry Weimer and Antonio Petty. Missouri controls it. Dixon trying to drive the baseline in no man's land, almost turned it over. Kashmir Wright, the last to touch it.
One of the things that Mike Anderson talked about with his Tigers is the young backcourt that they have, and having to nurse them through the Big 12 season. They played very, very well at home, as did most teams in that league, but they did not travel very well.
Ratliff.
That's going to be a very interesting matchup in the low post with Gates. They're very similar body types, the two wide bodies going at one another.
Tigers were one of those teams, Mike, that played a little differently from a defensive standpoint when at home versus on the road. They were able to get that frenetic full court pace up at home, but not so much on the road as Matt Cressy
gets to work early in this game. Or check that. That was Deion Dixon getting the bucket for Cincinnati. And it's 3-2. 2-2. Just underway. Third straight NCAA tournament opportunity. Ratcliffe had that one rejected by Gates.
Very nice job that time holding his ground, not going for the pump fake.
Little steal as they were trying to get the ball into Deion Dixon's hands.
Here's what you do. You hold your ground that time, and you bang bodies a little bit. The offensive player can't elevate Ratliff, and you get a hand on the shot.
Kashmir Wright, so good. When he does not play as well, Cincinnati struggles. Nice little crossover move and a winner. Loose ball taken off the deck by Denman. With the outlet to Dixon. Kim English, the junior from Baltimore, Maryland's got a lot of family and friends here. Denman not there. Bowers fighting for it. Last touch by Cincinnati. And it will be controlled underneath Missouri's own hoop.
Good job fighting on the offensive glass. And one of the things Mike Anderson talked about was matching the physicality of Cincinnati. Having to go through the wars of the Big East, so it's a different style of play.
English off the front iron. Ratliff, after Ibrahima Thomas could not reel it in, the loose ball, he picked it up and dropped it through. Traffic. Dixon. Ratliff gets the rebound.
Ryan, if Gates is going to get anything inside, he's going to have to do it quickly. There were three Tigers around him in that play, and they really swarmed to the post.
Bowers, baseline extended. Mizzou out to a four-point cushion. Not quite 3 minutes gone by.
Bowers, a mid-range player, does not have a three-point shot, averaging 12 points, but does shoot at 54%, Tim. He's a solid, solid shooter.
Dixon threw that one up like a grenade.
I think that was a lob to Thomas that he didn't recognize.
Denman. Mizzou out to a great start, a 7-0 run, and they lead it 9-2, just underway in a timeout.
Struggling early against Ben Howland's team. Mike, you and I had Michigan State in Michigan a little over a week ago, and their problems continue offensively.
Well, yeah, and it's just a lot of turmoil, and you got the sense that Tom Izzo this was a very tough year for him. Yeah. Having to dismiss Chris Allen in the summertime and then Corey Lucius right there in the middle of the season. The first time he's ever had to do that with two kids. Yep. So just a lot going on there.
Boy, a turnover. The 5-second violation, as you see. Cashmere Wright stymied by that Missouri defense. And, the Tigers get it back.
Well, there you see the what they do nationally, second in steals, fifth in turnovers forced. And right now, I think it's early in the game, but Mick Cronin saw that Missouri was really dictating tempo here early, and he wanted to get his team back and talking about it.
Denman needs a little help. Dixon comes over to give it to him. Sophomore from Kansas City feeds English. Really good spacing for Missouri in their offensive sets. Wright comes down with it. Darnell Wilkes, high-energy senior on the floor now for Cincinnati. In the game for Dixon. Gates backing in and really being pressured. Wilkes just into the game. Darnell, the senior, Nashville, Tennessee.
Well, he really bailed him out in that time, Tim. He averages under 4 points, and Missouri did a nice job of pinning it on that side of the floor. They got nothing out of the post inside the Gates.
Denman hates the rebound. There's that high pick by Gates, right? Going reversal, and Gates the follow.
Well, what a burst around that screen. And, you know, you set the high screen roll like Gates did, and you roll right to the front of the rim.
Nice move to the basket by Dixon, and he's tagged. And the foul spotted underneath. It goes against Cincinnati. Oh, the pick and roll with a follow by Yancy Gates. And how about the performance he had with UAB a few years back? And I know Storman Norman Stewart has to be proud of him, too. One of the all-time greats who never got to a Final Four.
You know, that program was in a tough situation when Mike Anderson got there, and he has got it turned around very quickly.
One of the hottest commodities of coaching. Very comfortable in Columbia, Missouri, and has made everyone aware of that of late. You see Phil Pressey coming onto the floor, replacing Michael Dixon. Flip, as they call him, freshman from Dallas. He and, of course, brother Matt on this squad, and means so much to this Missouri squad on the relationship with father Paul Pressey. And you alluded to earlier, a guy you played against and know so well. Pressey comes away with it, gives it up to Denman. All the way to the rack, high, arching off the glass. Oh, that was beautiful.
Well, Ian, you talked about it in the open about imposing wills, and right now Missouri is doing it against the Bearcats. Getting out a little full court pressure here defensively. They want to speed this thing up.
Wilkes, oh, rejected. And the outlet, beautiful tap out. And the foul. English is fouled and goes into the Cincinnati cheerleading corps.
Well, Larry Davis did a nice job getting back that time to stop an easy two. This is what they do. Denman putting it high off the glass. He said they want to play a game in the 80s.
Davis, the senior from Houston, picking up the foul, as you mentioned, but probably a wise choice. Make him earn it at the free throw line. And he misses the first, does he? Junior from Randallstown High School. He's so into the game, he sometimes, they say, sleeps in the locker room. Does
Ken English.
And after their loss in the Big 12 tournament, he called his team out, said they weren't playing with enough energy on either end of the floor. And that's, you talk about one thing that you have to have in playing for Mike Anderson, that's it.
Matt Pressey comes into the game replacing English, number three, in the black and gold of Missouri.
You talk about their dad, Paul. He was the original point forward for Don Nelson up at the Milwaukee Bucks in the early 80s.
What a player.
A lot taller than his son, yeah. Though.
They took after Liz, the mom, who was also a hooper of sorts. In fact, that's what they called her, was hoops. Cashmere Wright dropped through a deuce.
14-9, Missouri. Tigers will fast break off makes. Not many teams do it as well as Mike Anderson's. Bowers from downtown.
Yeah, I think of teams, and maybe the University of North Carolina gets it up as fast after a made basket, that similar tempo. So you can't, you know, the tendency is when you make a hoop against them to relax a little bit, but you have to immediately convert to defense and get turned around.
The other thing that they do, and Justin Safford's on the floor down, number 23 from Missouri. Unlike a lot of teams in this day and time, as a foul is picked up, Bowers and Pressey coming over to defend against Wright, and it goes against Bowers, is they'll run 10, 11 guys in there. What Mike Anderson asks, G-Man, is that you play as hard as you can for a short amount of time. I've got reinforcements, and I'm going to give you a blow when you need it.
Yeah, they've got five guys who average double figures, eight players who have more than 30 assists in the game, so there's an equitable distribution of stats.
You'll see the horn at the scores, or hear the horn at the scores table go off many times. It's like being at a bus stop when Missouri's playing. Gates from downtown. Beautiful. The junior from Cincinnati is with Rohide. Drops it through.
Wow, 17% from three. I think he got tired of seeing double and triple teams in the post. He wanted some breathing room.
That was his third of the season. He was 2 out of 12 coming into tonight's game.
Stop and go by Flip Pressey. Rebound to Jackson.
Out with the Cashmere Wright. In traffic, he's fouled.
There it is. They're one of four teams in the NCAA that has five guys scoring in double figures. Marcus Denman, the leader, but you see it up and down the lineup. Everybody gets an opportunity.
Steve Moore picked up that foul, number 32, just came into the game a few moments ago for the Tigers.
We invite you to get all the March Madness highlights, box scores, and the TV schedule for TBS, CBS, TNT, and True TV at NCAA.com. Well, in the earlier session, the early evening games, chalk was the lay of the land after a very exciting and upset-filled afternoon of games.
And, you talk about this game, but I think the guy at the free throw line, Cashmere Wright, has settled into this game. I think he was a little shell-shocked in the first couple of minutes, but he has grabbed control of things, and he's gotten his team back into this ball game.
7-0 run to tie it at 14. Pressey turned it over, took an extra step on the jump stop. Keep an eye on this freshman just into the game for Cincinnati as Mike Anderson looks on Sean Kilpatrick, freshman from White Plains, spent a year at Notre Dame Prep. He's a 21-year-old redshirt freshman. He played it a while, and just as I mentioned that, he turned it over. Got his pocket picked by Pressey. Dixon answers right away. Welcome to the scramble from Missouri against the freshman Kilpatrick.
And I can't think of a pace that's tougher to come off the bench into than playing Missouri. It's like trying to hit the highway at 75 miles an hour right on the on-ramp.
We have great regards for Kilpatrick. He's got fantastic talent. Wright gets it inside, and a strong move to the hoop that time by Justin Jackson. Another freshman out of Cocoa Beach, Florida.
Moore lost his dribble that time, was really bothered defensively. Great work by Ibrahima Thomas on his hip. 11-17 remaining in the opening half. Bit of a tug of war between these two teams trying to establish control of pace of play. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski, and Lewis Johnson here in Washington, D.C. Dixon's back on the floor for Cincinnati. Cashmere Wright getting a breather. Larry Davis on the floor as well. Justin Jackson coming off that made a moment ago is fouled. I believe they may have tagged Michael Dixon, and they did with the foul. Coming up on AT&T at the half, scores and highlights, the latest tournament news and Naismith Watch presented by AT&T. That's all coming up on AT&T at the half.
And now Lewis Johnson talked about Rashad Bishop and that turf toe and cruising along now, but all you have to do is get it dinged once, and that just, you know, we said yesterday, if he comes out of the ball game, we'll know why.
Moore with the rejection, and Dixon with the three ball.
Michael Dixon just under 40% from three, so very capable, and they will look for that shot in transition.
After a made basket, that means Missouri can get that pressure set up. The difference with them versus just about anybody, right, Mike, is you never know where it's coming from in the Anderson, Nolan Richardson way of doing things.
Well, and then the only thing I'd say then is you also don't know at the end of the game who's gonna,
<That's> right.
where it's going to be coming from.
Yep. Here's Bishop with a stop and go. Out there, Dixon cleans it up, and he's fouled by Moore. Well, Moore, a rugged, tough guy inside, taking up some space and picking up another foul inside.
Well, here's the good help coming over, and this block is really the first part that ignites the fast break. And then you see Michael Dixon pulling up, a terrific free throw shooter and a good three-point shooter.
A couple of Tigers and a couple of Bearcats waiting to enter the game. Tigers come with Ratliff and Ricky Kreklo, the freshman from Columbia, Missouri, into the game for the first time. They get Moore out of the game because of the second foul he just picked up, along with Flip Ressi.
Well, and you talked about what Mike Anderson gets out of his bench in the 5 years he's there. They've averaged 25 points per, which is outstanding production, but it speaks to the confidence that he has in those next five guys.
Yancy Gates back on the floor for Cincinnati, along with Darnell Wilkes. Justin Safford. Pressing, pulling up, that's an air ball, and underneath, foul spotted. Wilkes got tied up inside with Ratliff.
Rashad Bishop is going to get that foul.
Well, tag Wilkes will. Darnell Wilkes gets the foul. Pressy leaves the game. Matt Pressy, check it out. Justin Jackson will check in for Wilkes after his second is foul is given. Nick Cronin trying to protect him a bit before the intermission. Nice deflection that time. Deion Dixon almost coming away with a pilfer. New jumper won't go, and a quick outlet. Boy, a run out. You don't see many of those. All the way to the rack. Count it. And the foul by Davis. Boy, Davis, like he was shot out of a cannon. Not many times will the Missouri defense be unbalanced like that.
Well, everybody caught along the baseline. I think Safford surprised them with that jump shot. And when that happens, you get fast break opportunities. And anytime you can get that against this Missouri team, it's going to benefit you. But Cashmere Wright, what a terrific finish.
And Davis picking up that foul, and Davis at the free throw line.
Larry Davis out. But that's again, I think they get surprised, and it was one of those instances where Missouri was in their offense and everybody was buried along the free throw line. There was no balance defensively.
First lead of the night for Cincinnati. The bench points 8-0 in favor of the Bearcats. And Rashad Bishop picks up the foul. You see a full complement of games. Out in Tampa. UCLA, Michigan State on TBS. Ryan Eagle and Jim Spinarco are there. Gonzaga and St. John's on CBS with Hearn and Raft. And Kevin Harlan, Reggie Miller, and Dan Bonner on hand in the Southeast. In Tucson, Utah State and Kansas State underway.
Well, after early on going at it, that Ricardo Ratliff and Yancy Gates have been real quiet in the post. Not a lot of touches in there.
Bearcats by two. They just got their first lead moments ago. Nice look inside to Bishop. Oh, ball fake and the reverse.
Oh, that's great balance inside. He really had a sense of where the defense was around him.
7-0 spurt here for Cincinnati. That ball was tipped by Deion Dixon. It belongs to Missouri.
Let's look at Bishop. A good fake right here, using the pump hook and then using the rim as your ally, going up with the left hand. That was a terrific low post move.
Luke Cronin just loves Rashad Bishop. He was one of those that championed the senior from Paterson, New Jersey, for possibly Defensive Player of the Year in the Big East. Very solid offensively, and it looks as though he's answered the call as to that turf toe problem that Lewis Johnson touched on at the start of our broadcast. Nice work by Bowers, a little show and go by Lawrence Bowers. He has four. There's tips and deflections.
And that time Jackson on the reception stepped back, did not have a sense of where he was on the court.
And Pressey, Flip Pressey, really started all that with the pressure underneath. Just up in his kitchen.
Yeah, and there's the play right there, just ticking right there. The end line, stepping back.
Good call. Bowers, English, Ratliff, Denman, and Pressey to five on the floor for Missouri. Bowers off the front end. Look at little Flip Pressey keep it alive. Smallest man on the floor. Run down by Denman. Pressey in amongst the tall timber. Comes up dry. Yancy Gates pulls it down with the outlet to Bishop. Right back in the game. Count it. He's got 11.
Catch here right, 35%, and I don't know, you know, that it looks like still right now that Cincinnati is getting sucked up in the pace of the game that Missouri wants to play, but they've got the 5-point lead.
Ratliff answers with a tray.
All of a sudden now, the bigs have turned into jump shooters. Both Ratliff and Yates getting outside.
Ratliff with 7 points and 3 rebounds in the game. Deion Dixon. That'll go the other way as Yancy Gates came in high and picked up the foul. That's number one on Gates.
Our tournament is sponsored by Miller Lite, The Hartford, and by Homefront.
Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski, you look at our game summary, the bench points with Cincinnati in this game. But, Mike, I thought you made a wonderful point just a couple of moments ago, and that was that while things are going well for Cincinnati, it appears as if they're being sucked into Missouri style of play.
No, it's been up and down, and the thing that Mike Anderson was concerned about coming in, they may be one of the poorest rebounding teams in the field of 68, but right now they are competing on the glass with Cincinnati, and it's those second-chance opportunities that are keeping them in this game, because Cincinnati shoot 53% on the game.
Missouri had a 9-2 spurt, got out to a 14-7 lead, and then Cincinnati answered and has led by as many as four, and Deion Dixon picks up that foul. A frenetic pace, which is something that Missouri would like to have, but the Bearcats to this point have been dropping through enough shots to more than hang with Missouri.
Yeah, little bit of a matchup zone now for the Bearcats.
Denman fires away.
When you go to zone, Mike, doesn't that isn't that to some extent intended to slow down the pace of play just a bit?
Well, I just think making the other team recognize it and change their offense and react to it, try to keep them off balance.
Wright splits the double team. Cashmere.
he's been terrific since the first 3 minutes of this game.
Ratliff tried to save it, but does right into Cashmere Wright's hands. A pull up for Wright. Long rebound, and Denman comes free with it. Ratliff, not there. Boy, did Gates bring that one down with authority. Wright alley-ooping to Ibrahima Thomas. I think he might have surprised him a little bit.
I thought, and they were lucky to recycle that play. I think in the last two possessions, Wright got a little bit out of control. Ill-advised three that time, and that lob was a little dicey.
Gates trying to take advantage of the mismatch against Flip Pressing.
And a rebound control to Missouri, and Jesse brings it back up, giving it up to English. Just lost his dribble that time to Bishop. Three on one now, Dixon.
Really nice decision to look off that time by Bishop.
And a timeout, Cincinnati with its largest lead of Wisconsin.
Well, Timmy, to you and G-Man's point earlier, Mike Anderson in the last timeout calling for the continued up-tempo basketball, telling his guys to push the ball up the floor, crash the boards for the rebounds. That last time out was really to get him settled, but again, he wants to see what's happening right now. Push it up the floor.
Well, and the thing is, too, Lewis, that the pace may not manifest itself in the first half, but it'll show up in the last 10 minutes of the game, and that's where he wants to get into Cincinnati's legs and keep this pace going.
That's the idea, no question. The old line from his mentor, Nolan Richardson, is Powers takes it right into Thomas, and he's rejected. The old line that Nolan used to have was, fatigue will make cowards of us all. Wright with under 10 on the shot clock, looking for a little pick and pop from Gates, well defended by Missouri. Bishop gives it up to Wright. One on the shot clock. It goes crying off of the front rim, and Denman is on the loose again. Rashad Bishop fouls him. 3:50 remaining. Electrifying acrobatics up high. How about this for a flying Walenda? With
3 of 7 shooting.
Very effective in dropping dimes, too. He's got 4 assists to go with it. You see 7 different players with a field goal for Cincinnati.
And for Cincinnati to play against this type of defense and have only 4 turnovers to this point, Nick Cronin has to like that number.
Denman at the free throw line. His overall shooting percentage is up almost 10 percentage points this year. The only player in the Big 12 averaging 15 plus points while shooting at least 50% overall and 45% from beyond the arc.
Well, you look, 50%, 45, and almost 80% from the free throw line. Strong numbers.
Yeah, Denman has been deadly.
Kilpatrick, the freshman, yes, and a foul. Sean Kilpatrick, keep an eye on him. We mentioned that moments ago. Very underrated freshman. As good as the Big East is, you can understand why.
Well, and he made the all-rookie team this year. When he scores 18 points or more, the Cincinnati team is 6-0. So his offense, a very big part of what they do.
I was asking Mick Cronin about Kilpatrick, if he reminded him of anyone he had been with before. And he spent those years with Louisville, and he said reminds him a bit of Reese Gaines. Those points, 11-0 Cincinnati, and on the reach, Cashmere Wright will pick up the foul. Well, check out the Powerade 4-point performance ranking system to get a peek into the science behind the tournament success. See where your team ranks at ncaa.com/Powerade. Wright's first foul will get Dixon to the free throw line.
From Fyatt, honestly, his dad, Mike, played at San Jose State. When he left, he was the all-time assist leader. Normally, that assist gene skips a generation, and the son is a scorer.
Yeah, his dad, Michael Dixon, Sr., so he is the junior. And when he did, as you mentioned, graduate, he did so with the understanding that he was a guy that was unselfish. Nice analysis from a guy that never really made an assist in his entire career at Duke.
So?
You're the
if you're trying to hurt my feelings, you're not.
It's late in the day, isn't it?
Even if it was the first thing out of the shoot, I wouldn't flinch at that.
I'm a play-by-play guy. I can't be embarrassed either. Counted and a foul. Nice move on the cut by Deion Dixon. And he'll have the and one coming up.
Well, it's been a lot of old-fashioned three-point plays for Cincinnati in this game, and Deion Dixon very strong. We talk about it. He'll move over, and when Wright is out of the game, he'll be the primary ball handler.
Ratliff got the foul, his second.
Dixon season high, 23 points against Miami.
Had been in a bit of a shooting slump before the Big East tournament. We're happy to see him get on track. Certainly makes a difference for a team that at times during the course of the Big East season struggled to score. The defense really had Cincinnati's back all season long. Kilpatrick. Oh, how about Thomas on the glass? Oh, yes! Counted and a foul. What work by Ibrahima. Young man from Senegal by way of Stone Ridge Prep and the transfer from Oklahoma State.
Well, and it's kept alive that time, and they're just playing volleyball on the offensive glass, but Thomas pushing his man underneath the rim. Great job just to get it up and get the possible two free throws, but now he's got a chance to get the three-point play.
Ring it up, says Kashmir Wright. Fourth and one opportunity in this half for Cincinnati.
And the Bearcats, I talked about it, was even early on, but they are starting to impose their will on the glass against Missouri.
Well, the pace may have been to Missouri's liking, but Cincinnati is filling the stat sheet.
And this zone has played also a role, Tim, in increasing their lead to 10 points. Missouri not performing well against it in the half court.
Good ball movement out to the wing for Matt Pressey.
Never hit the rim, no recycle.
Shot clock at five. Denman's got to put it up and does from way outside. And a shot clock violation. Mike Anderson's team on its heels just a bit.
Well, you can take a look at it. This zone pretty compact, but they're matching up against shooters. Good rotation. Cincinnati's got the length to get out to people.
...22-9 run for Cincinnati. And everyone's gotten in on the act. Kilpatrick off the bench. Wright leading the way. Long rebound and numbers for Missouri. Matt Pressey giving it up. Good defensive sequence for Cincinnati as they're able to get back in transition. Denman for three.
Kashmir Wright got away with the play that time. Gambled on the steal, came up empty, and Denman had a terrific look at it.
Minute 20 remaining in the first half. Bearcats have opened up their largest lead here in the last 5 minutes of the first half. And the Tigers are 2 for their last 14 from the floor. That's an offensive foul. Player control against Ibrahima Thomas. Boy, you know, he had a really good Big East tournament, and towards the end of the season, Mick Cronin made the comment that he stopped trying to show his skills with a jump shot and began to finish around the rim, and that has made all the difference in his game offensively. little perspiration on the floor. Cronin is really one of those gym rats that thrives on toughness.
But he's really been a steward to his program. He's from Cincinnati, went to the school, and just cares deeply about it. And that he has methodically built it back up after taking over in a very tough situation.
Absolutely. That was a very ugly situation. And as much as we all think of Bob Huggins, it was a very difficult situation when all of that came to a head. And Cronin was the perfect guy to bring in at the right time. You can see he's satisfied with the way his team has been playing. Kim English gets that foul, his second. His dad, Hep, as I mentioned, a scout for the Atlanta Braves, actually signed Chipper Jones, believe it or not, out of Florida, Northwest Florida region. His dad, Hep, is always at the games, one of his greatest supporters.
And Tim, it's for as much as we've talked about pace, in this game, it's very low scoring.
Yes.
And, you know, for Cincinnati, I think that Mick Cronin's got to be really happy with his defense, only giving up 28 points. This is a Missouri team that averages 81 on the season.
Nine different Bearcats have a field goal in this game, to touch again on that balance that we were talking about. Opportunity here for Missouri to get something done. 8 second, 9 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock.
And they've really separated themselves from going to this zone. That's been a big part of the first half.
Bressy and Dixon in the backcourt trying to create against that zone, find a crack in it. Underneath, just a tough take for Bowers, and Gates the rebound.
Quick outlet. Kilpatrick gets it back, a step in three, not there.
Too early, gives Missouri a chance.
Indeed.
I got a second foul early. I felt Stephen Moore, the junior from Kansas City. He's 6'9", he's 270. I think against Gates, And some of those other big bodies, Ibrahima Thomas, they needed him to be on the floor.
Yeah, because they, you know, Cincinnati really got out there in the offensive glass.
Bishop. Ooh, a little double clutch. There's Thomas. Again, the strength of going and getting those second chance opportunities has been a real catalyst for the Bearcats.
And the health of Rashad Bishop, too. He had a very, very solid first half.
Bowers got the foul, his second. And Ibrahima Thomas at the free throw line. A reminder to watch every tournament game live online with NCAA March Madness on demand at mmod.ncaa.com. Other action underway, Gonzaga having their way with St. John's, that game at halftime. They lead by 11. Other matchups you see up at the top of your screen. We invite you to become your own producer.
Well, it's been nice to see Steve Lavin has re-energized basketball in New York City.
Really has.
I really think that had as much to do with the excitement around the Big East tournament as anything, plus all those nationally ranked teams.
By the way, Gonzaga, Mike, won their 11th consecutive regular season conference championships. That's the most in succession since UCLA did it 13 straight times. You talk about an accomplishment by Mark Few and basketball craze Spokane, Washington. We were just there a year ago. He and that program own that town.
Well, and it's the thing that's impressive to me is that they, when they first started, were the poster children for the poster program for mid-majors.
Yes.
Now they're not. I mean, they are not considered a mid-major program.
Yeah, it's a surprise when they're an 11 seed. It is. Dixon off the ball screen by Thomas and a tip in by Gates. Well, Ibrahima Thomas just set a huge pick.
As I said, this is one of the poorest rebounding teams in the field of 68. I'm talking about Missouri, and it's really showing up in this game.
You said it, Mike. They need to get steals, leading the nation in that category, and the second chance points have just been piling up for the Bearcats.
It was like a pretty good jump shot that time, and everybody gets spaced out. And then maybe more of an opportunistic tap than anything, but still you get a hand on it, you have a chance to get it in the rim.
You'd figure they'd love to get Denman untracked in the second half. Inside, Ratliff can't connect. The leaner Tigers have struggled when inside the painted area.
Well, against this team, he's got the luxury of two ball handlers out on the floor when Wright and Dixon would get the turnover there.
English. Ratliff there to follow. Bothered by that shot. Shots being altered by the Cincinnati Bigs. Out of bounds to Missouri.
Pretty nice job that time. Even though there was a turnover, usually that's something that Missouri's going to convert in the open floor. But Cincinnati getting back and not allowing it.
Kim English triggering it in. Missouri 0 for their last 12, and that's rejected again.
Ibrahima Thomas coming over.
Going back to the end of the first half, Missouri has missed their last 12 from the floor.
And this is, I think, that Denman has had trouble with a couple of things. One, the size of Dixon trying to play over the top of him, and then you've got help coming from behind on each drive.
After that rejection, technically it would be 13. And a player control foul will go the other way. Picked up by Ricardo Ratliff. Junior from Hampton, Virginia, Keoghan High School. Played his junior college ball at Central Florida Community College. As Ratliff leaves, Steve Moore comes back on the floor.
Here's a look. That would have been a nice block for a pulling guard in the NFL, but not a good screen in basketball. And you just see the body language not good for Missouri right now. They're not energized. They just seem a little deflated right now.
I think Mick Cronin was curious as to whether that forearm shiver might have been a little too high. He wanted to make the officials aware of it. 9 minutes and 32 seconds now since the end of the first half and the opening moments of the second since Missouri scratched from the floor. Dixon off the bounce. Flip Pressey comes down with it. Gets it quickly into the hands of English. See if Moore can be a factor. Coming in, number 32. We talked about that size of his and how he can battle with the likes of Gates and Ibrahima Thomas.
Well, we talked about tempo with Missouri, and that was an awfully quick shot when things aren't going well. I think you have to explore your offense a little bit more, but English trying to get them on track.
25% they're shooting from the floor as a team. Shot clock under 10. And there's Moore with a quick outlet. Numbers now for Missouri. Flip Pressey leaves it for Denman. The trailer knocks down the tray.
That's one of the few good looks that he's had, and that was a nice play by Pressey to get in and penetrate a little bit and set up number 12, Denman, for the shot.
Just his third field goal. He has 10 points on the night. Bishop pulls up. Rashad Bishop has answered the call.
That's tough for a lefty to curl right and stop and nice mid-range jump shot.
Whatever that toe problem was, turf or hardwood, he has apparently worked through it. English feeding Pressey. Double clutching in the paint. And there's Bowers with a putback opportunity, and he's fouled by Rashad Bishop. Cincinnati leads it by 14.
Stretching it out. Little after 10 after 11 o'clock here, and the Missouri Tiger trying to get loose.
Yeah, you're going to join me for that yoga class, aren't you, tomorrow morning? Get coverage of the Division I women's basketball tournament at NCAA.com/Final Four.
It'll be part of the sleep study program tomorrow.
Bowers gets the two to go. One thing, though, and Ernie, fear not, that Missouri can always scramble you up. And because they lead the country in steals, a few of those and a couple of jumpers go down. And with
three-point shot and where it's located in college basketball, things could tighten up very quickly here in Washington.
Gates in traffic. The whistle came a little late. I don't think Mike Anderson's going to be too pleased with that foul. It goes against Steve Moore, and that's his third, and that's the guy they really need on the floor.
Here's the look, the good jump stop there, and
I don't know.
Maybe a little play on. I think that Yancy Gates got bailed out on that play.
That's a lot of leather. I agree with Mike Anderson on that one. I do. You know, the way they like to play, we talk about Pittsburgh, how tough they are and how they like to use their hands. That's another factor for Missouri. You know, their style is different, but they love to use their hands. They do. But players always have to adjust to the way the game is being called. Part of the game they play.
Well, and you know what, Tim, as a player, I just...
Look at English. Just like that.
Yeah, and good. This is now looking like a little bit more energized Missouri team, but I was going to finish my point about the referees, that you would establish how the calls are being made in the first 4 to 5 minutes of the game, yeah, and then adjust accordingly.
Yeah, and I think that's the reason Anderson was upset. Right shot too strong. Loose ball. Last touch by Bowers. That was English's first field goal a moment ago that he got on that run out. And Larry Davis comes back into the game, and Ibrahima Thomas sits down for Cincinnati. So they get a little smaller. Although Gates is still out there for Nick Cronin. Kilpatrick. Hang time off the glass and one. Boy, this kid is special.
Well, it's been Kilpatrick and Bishop who've been doing it off the dribble. And how many three-point plays has Cincinnati had in this game in the old-fashioned kind, absorbing contact and finishing?
And Moore picks up his fourth and will have to sit down. And, that becomes a problem for Missouri on the glass.
Well, without Ibrahima Thomas out there, it's a much smaller team for Cincinnati. Much quicker, better off the dribble.
Five times they've had old-fashioned three-point opportunities, Cincinnati, and made good use of it. Flip Pressy. Will stop and go to get past Wright. Denman with the feet on the wing. And it's nailed by Stafford, a senior from Bloomington, Illinois. 48-37. First bench points of the night for Missouri coming from Stafford. On the wing, Davis. Too strong. And there to clean it up, Kilpatrick.
That's where that rebounding comes to hurt you. The initial defense, fine. You make a miss and miss badly, but it's almost a pass underneath.
13-2 in second chance points for Cincinnati. Pressy leaves it on the wing for English. Pulled down by Gates.
Good sense of tempo by Wright that time.
Fought through a number of knee injuries. Probably will have to have it drained at the end of this season. Nick Cronin's really proud of the way he's fought through some of the difficulty, and Wilkes takes steps and it goes the other way. Darnell Wilkes. And fear the skies, face the enemy, fight for survival. From TNT and DreamWorks Television, Falling Skies. The series premiere is this June, only on TNT.
Ricardo Ratliff also in for Missouri.
Bowers leaves the game. And back on the floor is Ricky Kretlow, the freshman from Columbia, Missouri, number two. He's got the ball right now, working on Kashmir Wright. Six and a half minutes gone here in the second half. Our finale from Washington. Denman with a beautiful dunk down to Ratliff. That was well conceived.
Well, from that angle, he should have been able to make a pass against the zone like that, but good sight line that time, good finish.
The ball was kicked by Safford.
Well, anytime the ball is knocked out of bounds, there's that pass we were talking about. Beautiful bounce pass entry.
Yeah, it really got Gates put on his back that time, able to get the deep entry pass and the easy finish.
Rashad Bishop comes back in for Davis. But what Missouri needs is more opportunities to defend inbounds passes. That's when they can get their pressure set up.
Well, that's the problem with shooting 29% in the first half, yep. That weren't able to do that as efficiently.
Well, Patrick. Nice look inside the Gates.
Good finish. Boy, you talk about Kilpatrick and being able to make plays as well as score the ball. That was terrific.
You know, this region, both the afternoon in the southeast, tonight in the west, does have a clear Big East flair about it with Connecticut, Pitt, and Cincinnati. And, Mike, the thing I take away from watching all three of those teams today is going through that kind of conference and the strength of the teams you play, 1 through 16, has got to prepare you well for the NCAA tournament.
I don't understand how coaches keep their sanity in the league that year. You can't look any farther ahead than your next opponent.
Cressy with a floater, a little rainbow. Touched the 10 but went down, and a steal by Cressy.
This is where you need your bench to step up, and they've answered the call.
Flint Pressey with a tray, and it's 52-44.
Starters did not have good body language in the first 4 minutes, but the bench has come in to give them a little spark.
Just as we mentioned, leading the country in steals, opportunities, chance to scramble it up and impose their will on Cincinnati. In traffic, nicely done. Justin Jackson, the freshman's been very effective. 54-44. Safford. Loose ball. Boy, Pressey's really getting to those 50-50 balls. Number one in the black and gold. 10 minutes on the dribble drive. And he's fouled. Gates. Got him, and for Yancy, that's his second. The Bearcats have the lead, but the Tigers claw away. We'll be back. 44, Cincinnati with the lead over Missouri as Big East meets Big 12. Our tournament summary. Well, the Atlantic 10 with a great day, and Wisconsin for the fifth straight year in the tournament gets a victory. Among the many items that we have headlined on this first full afternoon and evening of NCAA tournament play in 2011. Ratliff with the ball fake. Nice work on the offensive glass. A rare second chance opportunity coming from Missouri after Krecklow's rebound.
Well, there have been more of them, though, in this second half. They've done a better job on the glass.
Sufford rejected. Out of bounds, it belongs to Missouri. And Mike Anderson up barking a little bit. He felt there was some contact underneath. They could cut it under 10. Make this a three-possession game. It could help their confidence as we reach the halfway mark of this final half. Safford. The jump hook does not go. Again, a 50-50 opportunity. Pressey's got it. Flip getting it done.
Little tap out that time. Just making hustle plays. The bench really giving him a lift.
Yeah, his dad, Paul, would be proud. He was referred to by Mike Anderson, his old roommate, as Pablo. There he is again. The Mighty Might. He's got Safford with him. Bang! Zoom! Here comes Mizzou.
Well, Dixon that time falling asleep on the play. Deion Dixon, and what a nice pilfer by Pressey.
11 of the last 13, G-Man, have come by the bench, and they were shut out in that category in the first half. Davis leaves it for Gates for a slam. Let's see if Missouri can continue to pump up the volume. Their defense improves when their offense makes shots. Pressey again. Oh, the iron unkind, and it's pulled down by Justin Jackson.
That's the thing. Just the margin right now for Missouri. That hole was so deep to come out of, but I'm impressed with the second unit.
Jesse is just trying to get into every nook and cranny he can defensively to come away with a pick. Jackson again on the glass. Back to Gates. Would have counted had it gone. He'll get to the line for two. Boy, this was just a grand larceny here.
Yeah, just picked his pocket. Wow. The loss of concentration and getting out. Only two steals in the first half for Missouri. Much better here in the second. And then the nice bounce pass and finish. Love the bounce pass in the interior, Tim. Tough to get a hand on it.
Ratliff got the foul, his fourth for Missouri. Yancy Gates at the line. Matt Pressey comes back onto the floor. Denman sits down, as does Flip Pressey. Those guys really played hard, as you mentioned. Flip Pressey especially, as well as Ratliff. They take a seat. And a reminder, you see a full complement of games underway, including that Gonzaga-St. John's game. Michigan State and UCLA winding to a close with a late flurry coming from the Spartans. Kansas State and Utah State locked in a good one.
Right, this is tough. I mean, you've got to block out in a free throw situation. You can't allow a recycle like that if you're going to try and claw back in the game.
Bill Patrick along with Kashmir Wright in the backcourt for Cincinnati.
And I thought their offense really bogged down with him on the bench. Let's see how they respond to him back at the point guard.
Bishop. Boy, beautiful sweeping move by Rashawn Bishop. Mick Cronin's right about him. He's a difference maker. No doubt about it.
Especially when he can get to that left hand.
Heart and soul of the team. Let's go from downtown, 59-51. Krekow again hustling on the defensive end.
Only 28% from three, so found money right there.
Eight and change remaining, and Cronin's team now being challenged by Missouri.
We talked about it, Tim. The cumulative effect of this pressure, will it show up in the last 5 minutes of this game?
14 bench points in this half. Tanata in half number one. Ibrahima Thomas.
Great up and under post move that time.
Without Moore on the floor, Missouri just does not have an answer for either Thomas or Yancy Gates when they get it close to the cup.
And that's the problem. Just with a couple baskets, the lead back up to 10.
Safford setting the pick for Krekow.
Right now, Missouri a little stagnant against the zone, which they gave them problems in the first half.
Nearly turned over. Shot clock winding down and a giveaway foul by Wright. Kashmir slipping down that time to try to pressure. That's a bailout foul, his second. Ibrahima Thomas up and under and good.
Part of a 25-9 run, and they were down seven as we take it back to Washington.
Well, Ernie, no question, Michigan State with a lot of fight. Seniors like Caitlin Lucas, Delvon Rowe, and Draymond Green don't want to play their last game. They've had too much tournament success in their history to go down quietly, even against Ben Howland's Bruins. Michael Dixon back on the floor to play. And the follow, beautifully done by Bowers.
Just followed right in after the shot blocker. Nobody checking him off the glass.
Cincinnati's nine field goals this half, Mike, have all come in the paint. Anytime they've gotten close to the rim, they have been very productive.
Nancy Gates getting a little bit of a break right now, so it's going to be on Thomas and Jackson in the post.
There's a pick for Kilpatrick, and he drains it.
Sean Kilpatrick.
63-53.
Kilpatrick now joins Gates in double figures. Really been impressed with him. Not a high-volume shooter, but has been very effective.
Krekow missed everything that time. Run down by
Justin Jackson, and he was on the end line, so it belongs to Missouri. Let's go over to Lewis Johnson. Lewis?
Well, in that last timeout, Mike Anderson was really frustrated with the productivity of Cincinnati's big men. He was telling his guys that they have got to get some stops. Get on the floor, get those loose balls. He said they were down 10 with about 7 to go now at 6.5. But they've got to find a way to just be tough in this last few minutes to try and advance to the third round.
Yeah, well, there's no doubt the problem has been dealing with those bigs. And with Moore out of the game with 4 fouls, it's just tough. Well, they can get turnovers in the backcourt, they've got a shot.
Yeah, they've got to get people to turn their backs out on the perimeter, but once it gets touched inside, it's too late.
Cashmere Wright has 11. The lead back to 12. Just a moment ago, they had cut it to 6.
Different team with Cashmere Wright out on the floor, Tim. We talked about it. As he goes, this team goes.
Safford. Nice move on his part. A little flash to the top, and from the elbow puts it down. Rashad Bishop, a glue guy for this team. Cashmere Wright, a true leader. And this guy, Kilpatrick, on St. Patty's Day, has been putting on quite a show. Tap out. Denman trying to run it down, loses it to Bishop. On the wing, Wright turns down the shot. They're going to utilize that clock a bit.
Yeah, again, good recognition by Wright. I think he had an idea to put the ball up. Mick Cronin barking out from the sidelines to get it out and recycle the play.
For instant analysis and highlights of every tournament game, log on to SI.com. Kreklo takes a seat. English is now on the floor along with Bowers, Denman. For Missouri, Safford as well, who's been very effective off the Tigers bench here in the second half. And flip pressing number one for Mizzou. Gates, too easy. Every time he gets it down there.
Well, they can't afford to commit to double team, and that's been the difference. The Gates that time had multiple dribbles inside. He's just too big for Safford to deal with.
15 in the game for Yancy Gates. English cut off by the bigs. Ibrahima Thomas and Yancy Gates just too strong for English to deal with. Cincinnati has scored on each of their last 6 trips. Gates looking for a step out 3.
Oh! Second 3 of the game for Yancy Gates, and that may have taken the heart out of Missouri.
Open the floodgates on Yancy's perimeter game. He's got 2 of them. He's got as many tonight from downtown, Mike, as he had all year from beyond the arc. Man, just like that, the lead cap.
Post-ups inside or second chance opportunities is a statistic that Cincinnati has dominated. They've played their game, and except for a brief flurry in the second half, Missouri has not been able to play their game.
Missouri was able to close to within 6, and then a 16-7 run. With the anchor, really, Yancy Gates. He had 8 of the 16 points in that run. He's up to 18 on the night. Denman.
Well, and the problem is that Marcus Denman has been ordinary tonight, and they needed him to be a notch above that, if not 2 notches.
Yeah, he had to be extraordinary. You're right. There's Flip Pressey again. Boy, he ignited Missouri during that run, and he's going to get to the line after the foul committed by Ibrahima Thomas. That's his 3rd. The little guy.
You talked about it, Tim. It's a team with a lot of pride and a team that didn't want to go quietly into the night. So showing a lot of fight. Even though when we saw them at Michigan, they looked like a very tired group.
They did. And
a beat up physically group.
Think about it, Mike. It's almost a year to the day when Corey Lucius hit that shot on the pass from Draymond Green. And if Delvon Rowe had not ducked, that pass would have gone off his head as they beat Gravis Vasquez and Maryland at the buzzer. And they were a mass unit at that point with all the injuries they had, including Caitlin Lucas's injury. There's Flip Pressey again, just causing havoc everywhere. He and Denman with a double team. And quickly, Mick Cronin gets the timeout. Kilpatrick with a nice job of controlling the basketball.
Pressy just will not stop pressing. We'll be right back.
During the timeout, a technical foul apparently was called against the Missouri bench.
And I don't know that it wasn't on Mike Anderson. He was out of the coaching box, and the thing that he was upset about is that Cincinnati was awarded that timeout. He didn't feel like they had possession of the basketball.
What if I think preferred a tie ball? Anderson was already a little bit upset with some of the calls that had not gone his way. I think particularly Stephen Moore. Losing him, he got three fouls in the first half, and then that fourth foul coming after the third, that was, as our friend Bill Rafferty would say, a little bit of a nickel dimer underneath. I think that got under his skin just a bit.
Still,
and he finally let go.
I'm really impressed with Cincinnati as a team and won their backcourt. Only 10 turnovers against a team that was one of the top in the nation at forcing you to turn the ball over.
Well, the free throws plus the ball, and Cincinnati looking to put a period on this victory in the second round. Dixon gets it to go off the glass. 74-55. Dixon, nice maneuver, and a blow by.
Michael Dixon.
And Deion Dixon answered by Michael Dixon. And Pressy just in every passing lane. His mom, Liz, has got to be awfully proud of him. And there's a lot of basketball in his future. Out of Episcopal School of Dallas, just a freshman. What's that old saying about guards, Mike? You hate to be guarded by someone that can get underneath you.
Well, that's it. But the thing is, with Flip Pressy, was when you don't see him, you know you're in trouble.
That's right. I got that Muggsy Bogues effect about him. Dixon too strong. Pressy runs it down. Oh, nice pass. Pressy to Ratliff. Flip doing it all.
I remember Mookie Blaylock back in the day used to always comment he couldn't stand
up. In the ongoing relief effort for the disaster in Japan, we invite you to log on to CNN.com/impact. Ratliff.
And I'm Nick Cronin, not happy with that. That's a quick 2 points off the press.
UCLA and Michigan State very close down the stretch. Only seconds remaining, 77-76. A one-point game in Tampa over on TBS. Wright looking for Gates. And a timeout called by Nick Cronin prior to Kashmir Wright's pass inside. 1:34 remaining here in D.C.
Papers ready for inspection.
74-61 here. That UCLA Michigan State game is down to 4 seconds over on TBS, so we welcome you to take a look at it. Our friends Ian Eagle and Jim Spanarkle have it. Out of the timeout, here comes more pressure from Missouri. And Dixon got tied up with Bowers. A little sign of sportsmanship there by Lawrence Bowers. And Dixon will get to the free throw line for Cincinnati. How do you see the matchup between Cincinnati and Connecticut based on the incredible performance from Kemba Walker and company tonight?
Well, I just think that they are playing at such a high level, and their confidence is at an all-time high right now, and it seems like they've come through that 5-game-in-5-day march in New York with no worse for the wear. They look very fresh today, Tim. Now, obviously, there's going to be a familiarity there, and it's going to be a little bit easier for the coaching staff to prep for that game. But, it was a low-scoring game, in Cincinnati, but UConn shot the ball very well. They shot 50% from the floor, 10 of 19 from three, and Jeremy Lamb was the high scorer in that game. They held Kemba Walker to only 16 points, but they were very efficient.
Yancy Gates got that foul, and Bowers with the hoop has a chance for the old-fashioned three-point play. Well, it was unavoidable for the committee when you've got 11 teams from one conference coming in. I realize they don't look at conference affiliation when they're...
Greg Gumbel in New York. Over on TBS, what was once a 23-point lead for UCLA is down to one. They're trying to inbound the ball. Let's listen in.
It's an adventure trying to get it in.
Honeycutt. Was there a grab of the jersey? Looks like Keebler gets called for the personal. So UCLA didn't even have to enter the basketball.
That's right here. You got a little hand on Lee from behind, and there's a grab with the left hand shaping up.
So Lee is heading to the free throw line. UCLA up by one. Mike Nance heading over to the scorer's table, and both teams will huddle up here. 4.4 remaining. Michigan State wanted to sub in, but no time came off the clock. You can't make a substitution.
Right.
Two shots. Malcolm Lee, first team all Pac-10 squad this year. 79%. The junior from Moreno Valley, California. First one. Knocks it down. 78-76, UCLA.
Let's see if Jones tries to keep Lucas from getting this basketball right now. Lee makes this shot.
No timeouts remaining. Lee missed it. Long. Knocked up in the air. Michigan State's going to have a chance.
That's a walk.
He traveled with .2 on the clock. UCLA is going to pull out a close one.
Let's see if he gets the motors going before he puts the ball down. Well, it's close.
We need 1 second on the clock. Let's send you back to your game.
Fantastic game off the bench for Mick Cronin, as so many of the Bearcats did. And they punch their ticket and move on.